हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन. सी, एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर द रेट ऑफ अ केमिकल रिएक्शन, द रेट इन विच द केमिकल रिएक्शन इज अकरिंग, दिस रेट इट इज़ डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द कॉन्सेंट्रेशंस एंड रेज टू द पावर ऑफ देयर स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कोएफिशिएंट्स. ओके, सी व्हाट दे हैव टोल्ड हियर इज, suppose A of A are reacting, B of B and C of C, they are reacting together to form products. So if we have to define or write the rate of the reaction, then rate of the reaction, it is directly proportional to the molar concentration of A raised to the power A, this stoichiometric coefficient, into the product of molar concentration of B raised to the power B and molar concentration of C raised to the power C. Okay, this was according to the law of mass action, and this rate, when proportionality sign it will be removed, a constant K will be put there, and this is equals to K molar concentration of A raised to the power A, B to B and C to C. This was the law of mass action, and after that there a term came which is called active mass or molar concentration, that is the molarity. And we know that molar concentration, to express the molar concentration, the term, it is enclosed in a square bracket. So if liquids are there, then we use concentration units, and the active mass of a substance is represented in terms of number of moles per liter. Here, if we have to define the active mass, or we have to write the active mass of a substance, then it is written in terms of moles per liter. Suppose active mass of a substance A we have to write, it means we'll represent it like active mass of A, like this in a square bracket. And if gases are there, then the term partial pressure is used. And partial pressure, it is the active masses. Here also we'll write the active masses. Active masses of a gaseous substance, it is represented in terms of its partial pressure. Okay, the partial pressure of a gas is proportional to its molar concentration. That partial pressure, it is proportional to its molar concentration at any given temperature. Now suppose this, for an ideal gas, PV is equals to nRT, we know that P, it is equals to N upon VRT, and if T is constant, in that case P is proportional to N upon V. P is proportional to N upon V, and the predictions, these predictions which were given here, they may or may not agree with the experimental facts. Experimental facts were telling something else. Actually, now here in rate law, we'll study about the experimental facts. The coefficients which we were writing here, these coefficients which we were writing here from the reaction, the experimental data were something different from these stoichiometric coefficients. Not all these stoichiometric coefficients are responsible for the rate of the reaction. That now we'll study about the rate law. This will explain something to us in detail about the rate of the reaction. The rate law, actually it describes the experimental observed dependence. Experimentally, when the practicals or the experiments were performed, it describes those experimental observations, dependence of the reaction rate on the molar concentration of the reactant. It is called rate law. See what is given here. The rate law, it describes the true dependence of the rate of the reaction on the molar concentration of the reactant, not the one which is written here. By experiments, we can find out the true dependence, how it is actually depending upon the rate of the reactions. Okay, so in the rate law, the rate of reaction is expressed in terms of product of the molar concentration of reactants. Product of the molar concentration of reactants, which with the concentration terms, these are the concentration terms, to the power, describing the true dependence of the rate on the concentration. See what is written here, A of A plus B of B, they were combining to form products. But when rate was written here, rate it was equals to K molar concentration of A raised to the power anything P, not actually A. Sometimes it is actually A and B only, but according to the experiments, it was found that for not all the reactions, it was A and B here in powers. It was P and raised to the, and concentration of B raised to the power Q. This is based upon the experimental data, and it is always given to you because we cannot calculate it by ourselves. This will be given to you always. Whenever you have to calculate out anything related to this, this will be given to you, the experimental data. So two examples are here. See, two molecules of N2O, they were combining with the molecule of O2 to give 2NO2. But actually, see, if we would have written according to the rate of reaction only, so we would have written rate is equals to K molar concentration of N2O raised to the power 2 and molar concentration of O2 only. But here what was found, that the rate, it is equals to the molar concentration of N2O only, not raised to the power 2, and not even, it was not even depending upon the molar concentration of O2. This is the experimental data. CHCl3, when it is combining with chlorine, it will form CCl4 and HCl. And here it was found after doing experiments that rate, it is equals to K molar concentration of CHCl3 and molar concentration of Cl2 raised to the power half only. Only half of its concentration and its concentration, whole of its concentration, they were responsible for the rate. This is the rate law, which tells us that the experimentally observed dependence of the reaction rate on the molar concentration of the reactants. It is called rate law or rate equation, or it is also called specific rate, reaction rate. Okay, and now see, rate constant we are talking, sorry, it's rate law. Now we'll study about the rate constant. Okay, this rate law, it is rate law or rate equation. Now rate constant here, the constant K, this constant K. Now we'll study about this constant K. It is raised rate constant or specific rate constant. So the constant K appearing in the expression for each rate law of the reaction, it is called rate constant or velocity constant, or it is also called specific reaction rate. Okay, this is also called specific reaction rate. So see, suppose there is a reaction in which A molecules of A, B molecules of B and C of C, they are combining to form product. So if we'll write rate, rate is equals to K molar concentration of A raised to the power P, concentration of B raised to the power Q, and molar concentration of C raised to the power R. This was found out by doing experiments. Now suppose the concentration of all these three reactants A, B and C, suppose it is 1 mole per liter. If this is also 1, this is also 1, this is also 1, all three are having molarity 1, then in that case rate is equals to K. Okay, so if we have to define this rate constant, we can define it like the rate constant of a reaction, it is equals to rate of the reaction when concentration of each of the reactant is unity. When concentration of each of the reactant is unity, then this rate constant, it is equals to rate of the reaction. Now see the unit of the rate of the reaction. See, rate is equals to K molar concentration of A, P, B, Q and C, R. This P plus Q plus R, it is very important. The next topic will be related to this only. And when we'll add these coefficients here, it is equal to N. And this N is called order of the reaction. Okay, this we'll study in our next topic. So rate K, it is equals to concentration of reactants raised to the power N. and k it is equals to rate upon concentration. So from here we'll see that its unit is mole, 1 minus n, l n minus 1 and second inverse. So this was about rate of the reaction, active masses, law of mass action, rate constant. Now in our next class we'll study about the order of the reaction. See, this question also you have to do. This all I'll send you in WhatsApp. Thank you.